Welcome to Web Style Press. If you are new here, consider subscribing and hit bell icon. In this video, we will have a look at how to use GitIgnore file, why we use GitIgnore file, what are benefits of GitIgnore file, why GitIgnore is important, which tech stack uses GitIgnore file, and all about GitIgnore files. There's a dot before GitIgnore in the file name. It's like a system file or hidden file. When we use package managers such as Yarn package manager or npm package manager, we install project dependencies. Project dependencies bring their own dependencies. All of it is kept in folder called node modules. Node modules folder grows with time. Packages or dependencies get old and obsolete as new versions of packages are released. Project uses packages as it needs. Package.json file keeps a record of dependencies that we have installed for our project. For example, this is package.json for my project. And it has got two dependencies, local tunnel and webpack. But if we look inside node_modules folder, you can see a lot of dependencies or packages here. But we have installed only two dependencies. By using npm or yarn, we can easily install all dependencies with a single command. Package managers scan package.json file and bring dependencies listed in package.json file. It is easy to install or uninstall packages or dependencies. This means you need node_modules during development and production. If you are not working on a project, it does not need packages, dependencies, or node_modules, obviously. If I remove node_modules folder from my project, I will need command yarn install or npm install to bring back dependencies. As you can see, yarn.log file here. So this project is using yarn. You can use npm or yarn. I will right click here inside the root folder of my project and click git bash here. I'm using git for Windows for terminal program, and I will use yarn install. And I will get back my dependencies. It's that simple. If you're not working on a project, it's taking up space in your system. If you have pushed project to GitHub, it will just sit there and won't run. Obviously, it will not need node_modules or packages while sitting in a repo at GitHub. Almost all of those packages gonna get updates over time. So why keep old packages? Node_modules folder can take up considerable hard disk space for a small project. We do not keep packages, dependencies, or node_modules in our PC or at GitHub. We also do not share these. You only need to share or keep your project with package.json file and not node_modules. When you will use your project, just run an npm command to bring back all packages in their latest versions. So to keep node_modules folder from being uploaded to GitHub or remote repository, we use GitIgnore file. GitIgnore file does not just keep node_modules folder from being uploaded, but you can also name any other file or folder in it as well. Your project may have other private files like log files, zip files, and database migration files, env files. You can ignore all of these files and folders by using GitIgnore file. You can create a GitIgnore file yourself, or there are GitIgnore tools that can generate boilerplate for any tech stack. Let's create a .gitignore file. Right click new text document .gitignore, and I will remove the extension. And as you can see, I have got another, you must type a file name. So I cannot create a .gitignore file like this. So I can open up my code editor and click at the folder, right click at folder and select new file, and then I can type name here .gitignore, enter, and here is this gitignore file. As you can see, it is here now. Or there is also another way. You can use terminal to create .gitignore file. Right click git bash here and then type touch.gitignore, enter, and as you can see, gitignore file was created here. So you can type file or folders to ignore inside this .gitignore file, like node_modules/ and then static.zip, static.log, static.logs, .env, error log, debug log, and so on. Now if you push this project to GitHub, files and folders mentioned in .gitignore file will be skipped during upload. If your project has got these files or folders, these will not be uploaded, these will be skipped. And for the tool, if you want to create .gitignore file, you can go at gitignore.io and then you can select the text tag, let's say node, select this node and create, and here is your .gitignore file. Just copy the contents and paste it inside this file. This will do a better job. As you can see, node related files and folders, and then runtime data, dependency directories, node modules and JSPM packages, and then many other things. Let's go back and you can choose React and create, paste, and for React you've got these files and folders. It also has got node modules to skip. So you can search for gitignore generators and you will find the tools that will give you better options to create gitignore files against any tech stack. Also, if you want to learn more about gitignore, you can find some resources here at github.com ignoring files. And then here we have got .gitignore by OctoCAD. You can find some common configurations here, compiled source packages, logs and databases, OS generated files. So this is a good template. And then here are some rules. Ignore all .a files by using static, but do drag this file even though you're ignoring .a files above with this flag. Only ignore the to-do file in the current directory, not subdirectory. So this is a good read. And also you can look at this guide. Gitignore specifies intentionally untracked files to ignore. Pattern format, configuration, examples, and then GitHub GitIgnore. This repository has got good examples and boilerplate for several tech stacks like node.gitignore, this is for node. Let's search larval, larval.gitignore. For larval you can use this template. So this is a good repository. You can find many templates for many tech stacks here. Good resource, a collection of useful .gitignore templates, github/gitignore, and then you have got this tool gitignore.io. So this is how we use .gitignore file, and it is very important. I hope you like this video. If you haven't already subscribed, subscribe to this channel and hit bell icon to receive updates. Join us on social media. Stay tuned for more updates. I will see you in the next video.